about how to identify and what it means to even have an identity in the first place. And, you know, am I Marcia, the kid who listened to Curtis Blow when she was 5, the same person as Dr. Dawkins who gets up and talks about it to a group of students at Brown or the University of Southern California, right? And in some ways, yes, and in some ways, no. And I think it's healthy to think about it like that. I think just because it's important to acknowledge history and hip-hop history as well, Eminem is not the first artist who has, you know, deployed these multiple identities in these different ways. You know, I grew up listening to the Wu-Tang Clan too, right? And they were masters of this, this group identity, this individual identity, and that then broke apart into these other pieces. And I think that's definitely something that was going on at the end of the 20th century and the beginning of our current one. And I think what we're moving into now, what I'm moving into now, is really seeing what happens when we kind of break that glass window and everything's on the floor and what we do with it. Do we choose to just leave it there scattered and see what happens? Do we try to rebuild something else? How are we going to do all that acknowledging what's gone on, you know, before? And what are we going to do with those parts that we'd really like to forget? Those parts that Eminem, for instance, is someone who constantly reminds us of. You know, these ugly sides of life, these horrible, evil thoughts we might have about the people we say we love. You know, how to recover from addiction, how to just wrestle with what it means to be a parent. All of these different things, I think, are coming to the fore for me now as I am approaching middle age. Not quite as old as Eminem, though, I will say. And so, you know, so it's interesting and encouraging for me to see that playing out as well. But in terms of the country and where we go from here, I think we need also to be really careful, because it's not just how we change as individuals and how our appearances might change, whether it's due to age or whatever it's due to, right? But that it's also structural and legal changes that go along with the ways our society is changing. So that justice isn't seen just in the fact that there are more people of color, but that justice is seen in that our laws have changed so that everybody gets equality of opportunity regardless of their station in life or where they come from, that everybody gets education, that everybody gets a shot, you know, at the life that they want to have. So for me, again, it's, yes, it's an interesting sign of what we might be getting to, but more than that, you know, maybe a time to stop for a minute and reflect and say, how do we want to go forward? Do we want to go forward as just these ever-evolving individuals, or do we want to go forward as a society that, you know, this takes me back now perhaps to my Diggable Planet's influence, but do we want to go back to a society that is more just for everyone involved, right? So, I think we're at a really interesting moment, and I think, for me, Eminem continues to remind me about what's new and interesting in these moments that we're now living in.